Hello guys, this is Paralao and this is an alternate to the Brittlebone Village episode. I chose the decision to raid them, but I would like to get to the outcast somehow before I raid the village though. So I don't know if I took the best decision, but I also wanted to make Noag Savager, you know, because if you pick the raiding options, he gains 1 point into this one also, and I wanted that. So let's see if we can still talk to them so we can pass through their village. Yeah, I'm actually curious.
Three gonna let the intro the also to reach the Brittlebone village. Though there were no time windows outside the temple, the gifts of spirits gave Akrog no rest, filling his mind with nightmares. The most vivid of them took place in the cradle, fires raging everywhere, and dying kin all around him, the hunters yanking out their tusks with their brittle bone tools. Akrog roars and slashes and fights, but it is pointless. His strikes pass right through them.
Okay, so I changed my build for this one. I wanted to make it an easy playthrough and just play these missions on hard, but in the end I just played everything on hard. I'm at about 6.5 hours at most, because I skipped every dialogue possible, almost. So it went quite fast.
This is it. The Brittlebone village is right ahead.
They have food?
It is true. The Moonkin need to get it.
Has the chieftain decided what they will do yet? Raid or peace talk?
Let me check something. Let me check. So, Noag has 5 in Savage Warrior. Let's see. We will peace talk so we can gain access to that city, and then we are going to talk to the outcast. Because otherwise I see no way of passing through the city to the west. Let's just talk to them.
Guards!
What is this?
Wait! The...
Who?
The Moonkin. We... The... We... want to talk.
Let's accept.
Alright. The Moon can accept the Brittlebone's invitation.
Great. Just meet me at the village square. When you're ready to talk business, then. And ye two. You're gonna make sure no one harms them. Alright?
You mean we's gonna let him in?
Something wrong with your ears? That's what I just said. I'll see ye at the village square. Alright? Try...
You know
Try
what?
Not to touch anything.
Let's just pass through the city and don't talk to them.
Not gonna eat anyone, are you?
Only the younglings.
What?
Just a little one of Zazka's jokes.
Let's just pass through the city.
What the? To arms!
Be calm. Chieftain Mayor, let them in.
What? Easy. They're on our side.
You will lead the way.
So now I did already play the...
Going now.
Oh, it's not open.
Not them. The trolls.
What else could they be, you dimwit? Kittens?
Fair enough.
Okay, we have to talk to them then. We have to take the quest.
Moving now.
Actually, if we were raiding, I'm curious, how would you get through the doors? How would you get to the gates?
Tiara, watch over us.
This looks interesting.
So over here, I learned about this. You have to put goblin soup over here, and this guy will turn into John Wick. Will kill you.
Grunwar,
like
ready?
That sort of things. But that soup is good. As soon as I get the money, I'll start buying for them.
Let Grunwar.
There you are. Excuse my people, they're just a bit flabbergasted.
Yeah, I'm gonna pass through this quickly. Okay, and I'll skip the green dialogues. If you wanna see them, check out the other episode.
All right, the Moonkin are here.
Now look. That was the idea.
The Moonkin prefer meat.
No, I don't like.
Meat. That is not much, trusted one.
Well, I'm sorry, but it's all we can spare.
All right, fine. What one?
He'd help.
The Moonkin crush the beast and get the
crush or slash.
All right. The Moonkin will find and crush the Wyvern. Akrog has spoken.
Right.
Akrog thanks, Chieftain Mayor.
It's no trouble.
Okay.
Akrog must leave.
Of course.
He is Grangwar likes this knot, Chieftain. The brittle bones will stab them in the back. Lucky that the Moonkin have such thick hides then.
Yes, so you know, in the first time I reached this place, I tried to get them, and I did. But then I went on with my playthrough where I traded with them. But right now we are going to check out the Outcast storyline and see how big that is.
With their chieftain. They will slay the Wyvern for the brittle bones.
The Wyvern? Oh,
it
good.
Might
go
be
on through then.
Grumph, no one question.
Affecting a few maps.
Norg understand why lightlings hate trolls. But Crumple tell Norg greenskins and trolls both shaped by Zerak.
Shackles, little Moonblood. And the greenskins kill trolls because they see them as animals, like their wargs. They think they are Zerak's chosen, and the trolls are just tools. And it is true. Zerak never cared for trollkind. He is like a sire who threw his own cubs to the beaks.
Since the troll who wanted Zazka dead. Lovely.
Forgot to put a point into Grangwar, so I can't use this unless I jump level.
So look, another brittle bone. And green skins. Crush sticks ready.
Yeah, so as I said,
trolls,
careful, chief.
So as I said, these guys appear on many maps. So I think they are tied to him. So let's make a deal for this playthrough. I will play with the Outcast. And I'll be ruthless in every choice I can be. Let's be mean. Only for the trolls, alright? In the trolls' interest.
What is no afraid? Moon can come in fleas.
Should we? No. You speak, don't you?
No. The brittle bone must have imagined that.
And you have a sense of humor. Color me intrigued. What's your tribe? Sunhides?
Let's click on these guys on every dialogue line for this one, because I am playing through his storyline, so let's have everything over here.
Moonkin.
Never heard of those.
What is the brittle bone doing out here? He belongs to the village?
Not quite. I guess you could call me a drifter. I go from place to place, guided by the eternal pursuit of happiness.
An outcast.
Maybe.
It is not usual for a brittlebone to be friends with greenskins.
Orcs. Easy, Narek. They're right. As much as I value these gentlemen, though, our relationship is mostly business. Traveling these parts has become quite perilous in recent days, and they protect me.
So they swore a blood oath to him?
Not quite. I just pay them well.
But why greenskins? Why not other brittle bones?
Oh, let's just say I've never gotten along that well with other humans.
Akrog understands. Chieftain Mayor asked the Moonkin to crush a wyvern for them. Has the outcast seen it?
That's my name now, is it? Yes, I've seen that beast. It's southeast from here, by the ravine. It's dangerous though, so look out.
It will not kill a troll. What is the outcast doing here?
Me? Oh, just wandering around. Business as usual.
Well then, the Moonkin will leave.
Actually, wait. I have a proposal for you. I wasn't quite truthful when I said I'm just a drifter. Fact is, I'm a trader of labor.
Trader of labor?
A slaver. That is what the outcast says.
What an ugly word. But, well, yes, I am. Question is, how would you feel about a little sideline? You bring me the villagers and I make you rich. Plus, you get to take anything you fancy.
Zaska has no love for slavers. But still, this could create cruelty, no? Even more than just raiding the village.
First, Zaska refuses to raid the village and wants to peace talk. And now, he wants to enslave them. There is no bigger sin before Magua than kin slaughter and kin treason, Zaska.
Good thing they are brittle bones, then. Zaska wanted to peace talk because it was the smart thing to do. Now, things have changed.
I like the way you think, my friend.
Yeah, so you can't make that armor without cruelty, without extra cruelty, because you need 200 cruelty overall, 100 for the key, 100 for the armor. So I only had 60, I think, in the end, when playing the good side, no, trying to be stock every time and trying to get along. But with this one, I think we will be able to get that armor.
The Greenskins want to make the Moonkin slaves too.
Yes, the Chainers. And that's unfortunate. I've never acquired a member of the Dark Races, and I never will.
Why needs the Outcast the Trolls for this?
Oh, several reasons. All good ones, I assure you.
The Brittlebone wants to make them slaves. The entire village.
That's right.
The Moonkin should just crush him, Chieftain. The Brittlebone is a traitor to his own kin.
My own kin? My mother tossed me into the gutter because she preferred the booze. Then my wife was killed because she was an elf. I don't owe my own kin anything, troll. But fine. It's just an offer. Take it or leave it. And before you get any stupid ideas, my green-skin friends have dealt with creatures your size before. Plenty of times.
What will the outcast do with the village Brittlebones if he enslaves them?
That depends on the highest bidder. But nothing too cruel, don't worry. They'll just get a taste of what it was like for me.
There's a dead troll down at the mountain. A fleshkin. Knows the outcast anything about the dead troll?
A dead troll, you say?
The outcast speaks true. Below the village.
Afraid I'll have to pass. Narek, what about you?
No idea what they're talking about.
There you have it.
Okay, guys, let's do this.
We have a pact. The Moonkin will enslave the villagers for the outcast.
Gentlemen, you just made me very happy. Bring them here, and my friends will take care of the rest.
Two things, though. The Moonkin will take the food from the village, and they will need something from the slaves, or the outcast. Something that... how to say it?
A symbol for their pact.
Sure. How about we discuss this when you've procured the wares? I shall remain in hopeful anticipation.
Zaska cannot believe Trusted One would do this. It is wrong.
They need to find cruelty, else the Moonkin will die. Akrog will pay the price.
Should we do both of them? I think we get the reward. You didn't used to get it at release because it was a bug, but now you can get everything that we might get from him on the peace side. So I think we should go back to the village. But I don't like it. We'll have to fight the same fight again over here. Even though we have a ton of summons now. Yeah, let's hope I can do it in the first try. Let me check. Do they have something over here? Go.
Let Zoska get a proper look.
I think I need one more to make the floor level 2.
Grunwald, we'll go there.
But why do I have to intimidate him? Let's teleport to the village. No wonder, could we rob the trader after that?
Please don't hurt us. Please.
Baita!
Brittle!
What? No!
Zoska thinks he meant.
Oh, the moonkin.
Oh! What a day! What a.
The moonkin found a dead troll outside the village.
A dead troll? Mm. Whatever that is. But no, I'm afraid I haven't seen any troll alive.
A grog.
Certainly.
Adventurer, aren't you? Come, take a look. I'm sure I've got something that might spark your interest.
Yes, actually, you can make a profit in materials if you pay attention. See, this one costs 750. Okay.
Good choice.
Let me just think of it. No, this one, no, this one will be dismantled, this one is worth to be dismantled. I only kept them just in case the outcast is trading with us also. Let's see, this one is worth 1200, right? And if you dismantle it, you get 8 of those blue thingies. Okay, but if I sell it, I get 24 potions, which I can dismantle for 24. So basically this one is worth more selling it than keeping it in this case. Yeah, not too bad. There aren't many options.
Troll. What a
Akrog wants to bar.
Certainly.
Axes, daggers,
but
swords,
there aren't many
the
options
traveler.
Though. So for us is a good deal. Basically 25, we get 25 of this and roughly for the same. Yeah. The same, this one 74. I think this one is even more profitable if we take it. Let's see. I'm not in the mood to put back everything. Roughly the same price. This one also we can make a profit. See, okay, 750, we buy everything. Yeah, 11 by 2 again, 15 potions or blue stuff profit, or roughly there, 22. Yeah, 17 profit. Okay, let me check this one now. This one, no, it's not worth selling. Even though if you sell it, you get one thing profit. Okay, but I will do this off recording. I just wanted you to see. There is a way to gain an advantage, and if you play on harder difficulties, you want to do that. Theoretically, because you want the best gear for yourself. And you don't have too many options to trade for them. Alright. Okay, guys, so the thing is that it's better to beat the wyvern first in order to max out your cruelty. So let's do that.
He is on his way.
Let's try like this to spread the damage.
At his service.
It's doable, but still, that ability is too much, man. So sometimes it kills you, sometimes it doesn't, it's just so random.
It is over. What a beast.
Come, let them look at the beast.
But he was hurt this time, right? You must defeat all enemies. Yeah, okay, I will try to defeat them.
Right.
We are skipping the dialogues. Because we have them in the other episode, in which I clicked everything, and in this one I'm not.
Grungwa knew this would happen, Chieftain. Let them go back and.
Look, Wyvern Cub!
I think you can actually let this leave. I think. If you want to, but I really want that armor for this playthrough.
Trusted one.
So.
They should look at these eggs.
Let's not call about them.
Moment. You know I've got to wait.
Yeah, so. We have to kill them as we have to enslave them as soon as we start talking to them, because I played through this part about 3 or 4 times to see all the different combinations, and if you talk to them and agree to take the food, even though this it's still there, you just have no way of enslaving them anymore. So we have to do it right away.
Can trusted one feel something?
Of course. Cruelty. Good thinking, Zaska.
Zaska, good thinker. A fitting name, he thinks. Let them pick up the shells.
These are ripe with cruelty. They should show this to the stranger when they get back.
The taking of an unborn life. It only makes sense.
It is true. Now back
I forgot to get the shrine blessing. Let's get it now at least. Yeah, I was a bit tilted over here, man, because and you have these unskippable dialogues that you have to hear all over and over again.
It worked. Grungwa feels like his blood is burning. He go there.
Even though. Okay.
Just wrong, Yorick. Tiara's breath. How can you not see that?
They were trolls.
Let's try
You're
to do them.
Sighted.
Look at this.
Guardians. They're back.
Akrog is ready.
I'm just trying to position them because sometimes they have such a weird pathing that gets you killed.
Friends.
The Moonkin.
Not your friend, bitch. You know what you did.
Bread?
It was a mistake.
You know what you did.
Akrog has changed.
Wait. What?
What? Enslaving.
They will
respect these guys.
Ready for action.
Can see much from here. Stay over here.
the blood for the tribe!
Yeah, let me just take care of these guys. I'm sitting here so they can heal. We'll make our stand over here.
Alright,
let's wait for the minerals. Okay. Alright, how many do we still have? 14? Let's keep staying over here.
What now? More trouble? Moving on.
Okay, let's go. Let's go.
Great. More problems to smash.
I can't use the summoning over here because I have no corpses. They don't count. Powerful.
May Magua guide his hand.
Okay, I think these are the last ones, huh? I have so many spells that I sometimes forget to use some of them. I have plenty of options. Okay, are they done?
Norok smashed the brittle bone warriors. Time to bring other brittle bones.
No! Guardians, please! No!
The warriors are dead. The brittle bones will come with them.
Monsters! You damned monsters! You killed them!
And they'll kill the screaming brittle bones too, if they will not come with them.
What?
No, I crushed them!
Akrog saw. Good work, little blood.
Love him.
Good job, Noank. All right, let's collect everybody.
Sure. Why not?
We had a gate over here. That's fine. All right.
Yes.
So you can't get the food until you deliver the guys, but you can loot the barons. Probably an oversight. Are they all? I think they are all. I think we cut them all. Let's use this gate.
Going now.
Yeah, so I'm not going to put up to put you through the whole episode.
Not surprised to see them. Strange.
If you are curious about all the dialogues on the peaceful path and all the exploring of this map, check out the original episode. This will be named as alternate, okay?
No, I don't look.
Because I'm curious about the outcasts, but I don't think really this is worth replaying the game for. It's at least from what I got, so I don't know, maybe it's worth replaying. As I assume these guys are not here for nothing.
Ah, here we go. Good job, my friend.
Are they 20? Are they all here? Two.
Zoska is listening.
Oh, there were two over here, man, at the foot. Let's go back.
Sure, why not?
And I don't have monkey in march, which would have made them move faster.
Let Grungoir take a closer look. Moving on.
Yeah, the padding could use some work, also the formations. They should always reform to put the melee in front. In this case, they did. I think it's just a coincidence. Let me check. Oh, look, they are doing it. That means I have to stop before fights. In order for... Okay, they are doing it. They should do it on the fly during the movement, in my opinion, not... Because when you meet enemies, they are not reformed. Ah, it's still a... Okay.
Brittlebone warrior's dead. Workers come with Moonkin now.
It's gonna be all right. Everything's gonna be all right.
Going now.
Yeah.
Yes?
Okay, so I'm not going to put you through anymore. I'm just going to deliver these guys. To the outcast, and I'll stop the episode over here. But I'll continue my playthrough because I'm curious how this guy plays a role in all of this campaign. And I don't remember because, as I said, I replayed bits and pieces. I mentioned that this time I didn't threaten Nerbok with death penalty if he doesn't obey me anymore. So we'll see how that goes. But if he... let's not talk more about it because I don't want to spoil the things for you. Alright.
My troll friend returns. So, how about our bargain?
This is all that was left. The others are dead.
I see. Tragic indeed. Color me impressed. This is a far better harvest than I had hoped for. Excellent work, my trollish friend. Excellent work. Narek, herd them up and put them in fetters. We're leaving at first light tomorrow.
You got it, boss.
Now, on to your reward. I have no coin, so hope you can make do with these ingots. You said you needed something else, too? Something symbolic?
These are interesting.
That's not exactly an answer to my question.
No. Akrog thinks he needs nothing more. These shiny blocks, they are brimming with cruelty.
Of course they are. Blood money, as Brittlebones call it.
I'll just pretend I know what you're talking about. So you don't need anything else from me?
No. This is all.
Splendid. Well then, it was a pleasure doing business with you. Fare thee well. And I hope we see each other again.
The outcast is alone in his hopes.
Oh, and I thought we could all be friends. Goodbye.
What is needed of him?
Okay, so let me explain a bit to you. So, if you don't kill the wyvern first, you don't get the chance to break the eggs for those 30 cruelty. Pieces, and you simply don't have them towards the end. You don't get any options. I tried, I walked around that egg after I enslaved everybody. I killed the wyvern and I walked around the egg. The little wyvern doesn't spawn, so you can't break the eggs, as far as I could tell. So I guess this is the best way to maximize your cruelty if you want that that spirit mark armor. Okay, yeah.
Intruders!
Tiara's tits.
Kitten, wait! That Brittlebone is still alive.
What should they do with him?
Wait. That Krog knows this face.
Norfolk, look. At his service.
What is this?
Wait! Don't kill me! We can talk about this!
Hold on. I know ye.
You helped me with that village and the axe, remember? Brought me a whole lot of workers.
Akrog remembers it well. The outcast.
The kin traitor.
Julok, this Brittlebone helped the Greenskins enslave the Moonkin too.
It is true. Julok saw him bring two trolls from the mountain yesterday.
What? Nonsense. I told you, I only deal in humans. Your kind are my friends, remember?
Then why is the slaver here?
To discuss a future business opportunity. Look, how about this? If you promise to let me go, I'll tell you where I keep my stash and even give you the key to open it. Lots of shiny stuff in there, and lots of scrap.
Fine. He has Akrog's word. Tell them where this treasure is.
It's on the shore, southwest of the Blackheart jungle. The forest is swarming with Nadari, hard to miss. You should find a chest on the coast near impossible to break. Here, this is the key.
That sounds familiar. They have been there before. How can they know this is not a trap?
Well, the forest is dangerous, which is why I put the chest there, but no, it's not a trap. So can I go now?
Go.
Thank you. You did the...
Run.
Okay, guys, so this is the last time we see the outcast. The chest contains some cruelty, some cash, and some other stuff. Nothing really too important. I get the cruelty from other quests. So, yeah, I just wanted you to see the last bit of the outcast story. Sadly, those goblin cards play no role in the story. They are just, I don't know, maybe they are showing that the chainers are enslaving everywhere and their network is so big that they basically rule Urgard. Alright, so this was it. Thank you for watching. Remember, if you wanna see all the dialogues from the Brittlebone Village, just check the original episode, because in this one I kept only the outcast related dialogues mostly, alright? And I edited everything to make sense a bit. Thanks for watching and bye bye!